care at all. It might also just be incredibly boring as I finish all the content super easily, because I have no idea how hard or not hard the content is. So yeah, that's on the cards. That's it. Cool. About the pan. Oh, yeah. Sorry. I actually did open it. Okay, so I did open it. So honestly, so I guess first and foremost, the pun that XR is talking about, the $20 loaf. So I actually made fruit sando with it. It was interesting. Making fruit sando with American fruit feels so different. Yeah, like very different. Why am I? I'm muted because I had my audio muted because I was in a meeting during Europe stream, so I had a lot of things muted. Pain. I wouldn't have gotten the song anyway, so it's fine. So yeah. What was I gonna say? What's this? Okay, so the bread itself, very interesting piece of bread. By far the piece that's like the best white bread I ever had, but I never actually had, like, I never like went and like sampled like Japanese milk bread by itself. Like, you know, when I was in Japan, all I had was, you know, the end result, the fruit sando. So this bread was by far the best white bread I ever had, but not like by some like significant margin or anything like that. Like, it's by far the softest bread I ever had, but like, and like, it still tastes like slightly dense, slightly like flavorful. But like, if you're talking about like very minimal gains, it's like, if you care for luxury products and want the best white bread you can have, maybe it is something that you definitely want to consider. Otherwise, is it worth paying $20 for a loaf? Probably not, but that's going to be up to you. Okay, well, let's leave it at least that much. I actually don't get much bread from Asian bakeries. That's the weird thing to me, sorry. I actually do not get bread from Asian bakeries. I actually need to do that more often now that I went and did the jump. So I'll tell you next time I get a chance to go to an Asian bakery, except I live on the side of town, Accelerate, where it's pretty annoying to find an Asian bakery. Darn it. I literally had to go across town to know where you are to go get an Asian bakery. Like, yeah, so as you sort of might guess, like, I haven't been to any Asian bakeries, like, basically since when I was childhood. And, like, my parents are cheaper and, you know, would not buy expensive bread like I would. So, I never really actually have a chance to try one. But yeah, if I go across town, maybe I'll do some things. I might ask if I can go across town, my roommate. He might be going across town. I might just go join him. I'm not sure. We'll see what happens this weekend. If I happen to go across town, I might be able to go across town. I might not, though. We'll see. Because, you know, this is Fanime weekend, also Anime North weekend. Both conventions I've been to in the past. So, in case you ever wondered, I actually have been to Canada before. And went to Anime North, and I personally think Anime North is a fairly boring convention. Sorry to all the Canadians here, or the Canadians who watch this video, I'm very sorry, but I did not find Anime North to be a very fun convention for me, mostly because the only thing I care about is merch at the end of the day, right? I think the only thing you're going to expect from me to hear from me ever is like, merch, and more merch, right? And obviously, Anime North is not something that has a lot of merch. Like, Rainmaker. Which is what I was gonna say. So, like, Anime North, I'm going to go off topic because I still want to talk about Fruit Sando. But Anime North, like, had this one vendor that always had a discounted udon books and some other English translated items. So it was a really good source of just getting some of these art books that I really like to get at a very good price. Sadly, I haven't been to Anime North in ages, and it's not worth taking a full trip to Canada just so I can go pick up discounted books. But yeah, that's beside the point, right? That's really beside the point. Okay, Fruit Sound though. I didn't mean to talk about this for last 7 songs. Fruit Sound. So if you ever had a Fruit Sound in Japan, or at least know how it looks like, Japanese fruit, like Japanese originated fruit are not very large. You know, if you ever seen a Japanese strawberry, they're sort of tiny usually. But on the other hand, when my roommate came back with strawberries, we got these massive American strawberries, and they're big. Normally when you do a fruit sando in Japan, you put 3 strawberries apart with gaps in between them, and you line them up and you have plenty of space left over and whatnot. I got 2 American strawberries, just 2 of them, and they pretty much filled the entire thing without much gap. Across the diagonal. So, American strawberries are big. Because they're bigger, they're also a lot thicker too, which means you need that much more whipped cream. I was about to get to the whipped cream part, but yes, the whipped cream to fill in the gaps between the fruit and also make the prism shape, the rectangular prism shape that you normally expect from a fruit sando. So I like to use I was too lazy to go make my own cream, so I have a mixer, but I'm like, I hate making cream by myself. Like, I've made it once in a cooking class, and I'm like, dude, this sucks. Because, you have to mix the mixer on for, 5 to 10 minutes and check if you have stiff peaks or not. It's like, holy shit, I don't want to bother with this. Not worth my effort. So yeah, I didn't bother with that, okay? In case anyone's wondering, I'm just like, screw it, I'm buying whipped cream from the store. But yeah, we use a third of the container of whipped cream on one sandwich alone. And it wasn't enough to even make the prism shape. It was still it was falling down on sides. We used so much whipped cream. But yeah, giant sandwiches. It tasted like a fruit sando. I mean, I don't know what you think the taste of a fruit sando tastes like. It tastes exactly the sum of its parts. Fruit sando never impressed me in Japan. My roommate said, only the highest end Japanese fruit, very impressive fruit wise, but there are comparable stuff in America. It's just that you have to go, you need to know where to look for higher end fruit in America. In Japan, there are places called fruit parlors that make it very obvious where the high end fruits are. So in that sense, it's a little easier to access because you know where to look. But in America, what's it called? Is it David and something? I forgot what the name of that candy shop, or candy chain, high end candy chain. They sell high end pears every year. It costs $3 a pear or something insane like that. But those are some of the highest end pears available. Those will be very good. I never had them myself. I think I had higher end pears before, and they're pretty good, but I don't think I'd be highest end pears ever. I never really bothered that much because I'm never wanting to pay that much for premium for fruit. But beside that point, you taste fruit, cream, bread. Bread was nice, fluffy, high quality bread. Yay! So I'm sorry I'm not the biggest fan of things. The person I traveled with in Japan loved fruit sando and fruit parlors far, far more than I did. I was like, everything I tasted from those places really tastes like the sum of their parts. It just felt like, yeah, this is a great, great like base item and you put another item in and it's like, okay, that's that. It didn't really come together as a complete dish to me as much as, wow, this tastes like some of its parts. And they're good some. It's just like nothing better than it, right? At least that was what my opinion was. So, I'm sorry if I don't sound the most impressed in the world. But yeah, it tastes like a fruit sound though. Yay. So yeah, I did that. Okay, so, enough of that. So, today I went to, I bought some barbecued brisket over the weekend. Because I've been meaning to go to a place for some barbecue for like a long time, as in like 4 years now, 5 years now. There's a place I used to go to that was near my work. There's no way I'm getting A3 mini socks. But yeah, there was a place I used to go to like 5 years ago in a farmer's market, and they left that farmer's market, and I'm just like, well, I want barbecue from these guys again, because. Like, even after these 5 years, I would still say they are one of the best barbecue places I've tasted in all of LA. American barbecue, not Korean barbecue, okay? And actually, more specifically, like, I think it's a Texan style. Like, I don't compare it to... I had a North Carolina-styled... World's Strongest Doomed. I had a, like, North Carolina-style barbecue one. That felt so different. I don't even want to compare it to Texas style. It's just, like, such a different barbecue style that, like, the flavor you get out of it is not very comparable. Like, I won't say it's better or worse. I'll say it's very different, though. But yeah, those are the places I went to farmer's market, and it's like, wow, this looks good, but... Oh, I haven't been to them in ages, and then I went to finally research them, because I didn't know how to figure out how to research them in the past, and like my head wouldn't go get through Google correctly, so I finally figured out how to go find them, and I found they were in a farmer's market in Beverly Hills, so I went out to Beverly Hills, and it's like, yeah, I'm in Beverly Hills, got a barbecue, then from there I went to Fairfax to go pick up Thai food, strangely. I can have another story about that one some other time, but... yeah, so I did that stuff, But yeah, so I have barbecue brisket, so I wanted to try, you know, barbecue sandwiches, right? You have brisket, you have barbecue sauce, and you have bread. I've tried both toasting the bread and just eating the bread cold. Because they said just on the second day, since I unfrosted it yesterday. No idea what the song is. But yeah, on the second day, you're supposed to go eat the bread, you should eat the bread plain, because it's sweeter, but not as fluffy as day one. Day three, you're supposed to go toast the bread. So day two, I tried having the bread. I did the bad thing of toasting the bread on day two, but toasting the bread, all I can say is it toasted well, nice and sweet bread, and that was really all I could say about it. The cold bread was actually much more interesting. It tasted like I was eating a slightly denser Hawaiian bread on day two, but it was like, you know, in the form factor and everything of white bread. Is that really worth the premium of spending that much money for a loaf to get slightly different Hawaiian bread? I'll leave that answer up to the audience, but my answer is probably no, unless you really like that style, right? I think Hawaiian bread's great, just in case anyone's wondering. Yeah. If you've never had Hawaiian bread before, go get some. King's Hawaiian bread's great. Is King's Hawaiian bread the name of the company? But yeah, they have a King's Hawaiian bread. I'm pretty sure it's King's Hawaiian bread. Okay. It's Hawaiian. Let me double check. Yeah. Yeah, so So these guys, Kings of Wine Bakery, Zosli has two plants, if I remember correctly. One in Hawaii and one in LA area. I forgot exactly what city it is in. You can look it up, what city exactly it is. They're like one of the more like common Hawaiian breads you can find. They're fairly good. Like, I have no real problems with them, but yeah. But yeah, so that's my thoughts on the bread. I'll see how it goes tomorrow with the toasting. I still have a bit left, like a little less than a third left. I'm probably just gonna mess with you tomorrow. Oh well, I don't know how much money any of you want to shell out for bread, or anything like super pricey. What the heck? Kings of Hawaiian actually expanded out to the East Coast in 2010. I did not know that. So they actually had a third plant. Okay, interesting. I actually never knew that. Always not a fan of King's Hawaiian. Oh well. I mean, the one room about the same quality as all the other ones. Like, I don't think, like, obviously, it's a very certain style of bread, right? Because King's Hawaiian, you're only going to get that slider. You're only going to get the slider. But it's a nice sweet slider. It works well. Darn, I need to learn this. But yeah, if you don't like it, you don't like it. I'm sorry, or don't care much for it. Catch me if you can, my darling, you are so charming. But yeah, you're basically gonna get a sweet white bread that's like slightly more dense and fluffy feeling. Not dense? I don't think dense is the right word, but whatever, don't care. Can't think straight about it. Probably gonna need to try a few more times to say exactly what I think about it, and also compare other breads. I'm just not in the mood to say all of that right now, but sure, whatever, okay? But yeah, that's just my thoughts. I think that's everything I need to say, Accelerate, unless you think I'm missing something I need to say, if you want more in the review. Starlight Nanto. Cross F. Sorry, you don't need to hear me. Ninja Slayer, oh jeez.
같이 꺾어
꺾어 불을 꺾어 다
He sucks is very delayed. Okay, future. Song I probably know a bit too well. I'm the only one who put ignition? What the heck? Why am I the only one who put ignition? Initial D unlock. I don't know why, I just like putting in ignition just because I can. I'm just gonna do OG unlock regardless, unless like I have a feeling it's not. Which is not the case. Okay, yeah, and other news. Let's go talk about other things in life, right? Let's talk about other things. So, Quest will care about this. A figure for Palzio's favorite character is finally out. So, yeah, Palzio has a figure he needs to have, right? I sent the link to Palsy already. He hasn't responded yet, though. I think he's probably asleep. I'm guessing he's asleep. Actually, no. Oh, Herkel actually likes her? Makes sense. Is black or white? Or, it's black or white, right? Make sure Farkle can also get the picker himself too. What's this? I don't know. Oh yeah, it's something I wanted to ask Excel right here actually. Excel, what's your thoughts on how alive is Azure Lane? I've been hearing various things about how alive or not alive Azure Lane is, depending on how much of a doomsayer you are, but curious what your thoughts on it since the 7th anniversary recently happened. You haven't played AL since 2020, okay, never mind then. If it was dead for you. Like, I'm always very curious about, like, the state of mobile games, and added a cancer daily. Uh-oh. Jeez. I never played AL, so I don't know what dailies consist of. Accelerate, I'm sorry. I just got pissed at the fact that Azure Lane had, I thought it had, shoot 'em up style gameplay, except it had undodgeable attacks, and I'm like, why the heck does a game as shoot 'em up style gameplay ever have undodgeable attacks? It makes no sense to me. I didn't even bother playing because of that. That's actually my main reason why I didn't ever play. Game is basically full auto. I mean, yeah, I know the game is basically full auto, but... Well, actually, yeah, at least I heard that was mostly the case. Still. Ugh. Yeah, the 74. I'm usually pretty interested in just like the environment of mobile games, like how much money they make, since you know mobile games make the big mobile games make a lot of money, and I mean a lot of money, like way more than most like AAA games and whatnot, which is the scary part. Is like, look at what Nikkei has accomplished, and it's actually insane. Like, Nikkei has made, I think, about $200 million, according to numbers I can find, which doesn't include PC. But yeah, it's made, yeah, a lot of money, like, much more money than, AK is interesting. So, W? Is it W? Or is Zito engaged? F. Why did I put OG? Why did I put OG? Holy snap! Save me, save me, save me. I'm being dumb. I know, I'm being dumb right now at Quest. I don't think Azure makes that much. Well, I actually don't know how much money makes from Azure Lane. So Azure Lane's current monthly evaluation is somewhere between $3 and $4 million a month, which is not small, okay? Like, by no means a $3 to $4 million a month is small. For a game at least. Like, if you're talking about a big company, I'm saying but that's a different story, right? So, like, it makes $3 to $4 million a month from according to Central Tower data. Azure Lane. Not including merch sales or anything like that, so that's all separate. So it makes more money than obviously from everything else, you know, all the licenses and whatnot, but it makes a nice amount. Hello, I'm Atreus, welcome to the industry. How are you doing today? Very so I'm sorry, Matt, if this stream sort of isolates you. I don't know how much you would care about watching a music quiz, but yeah. we're talking about a bunch of various other topics. Playing Mario Kart Friends. Oh my, how was that? Hopefully that was a lot of fun. We're talking about mobile games, and we're just talking about, like, sales. Because, you know, money is the most important thing, right? Money makes the world go round. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Sometimes money makes the world go round. We're talking about, because Accelerator was talking about how Azure Lane was, and Eurostar makes most of their money from Azure Lane. I was talking about how they, from the according to the latest sales report, they make about $2 to $4 million a month from the mobile game alone, which is a pretty considerable number. Pretty considerable. But yeah, I don't really know, like, how many employees they have. Like, $3 to $4 million a month for a Asian company is actually a lot. Considering cost of living in an Asian country is far lower than it is in, you know, America or. At least, yeah, like, some, you know, like, the really expensive areas, right? Europe, like, America, like, actually, especially America. Mostly, mainly America, honestly. If you think about it, it's mostly America. It has the super, super high cost of living. Mode right now. We're playing expert ranked, which isolates pretty much everyone under the sun. Like, if you see me on this mode, I'm doing absolutely terribly. I'm not in the top box. I'm not even close to it. So we're just doing random talking. I don't know. Like, is like $3 to $4 million enough for Eurostar? I've always wondered. Like, what do these companies do with their money? Like, You could pocket it. Just give it to your employees. Oh, this is good. I'm blanking. Do you mind? Oh, turn savers. I can't do dirty water. Help. But yeah, I'm always like curious, like, if you make so much money, how do you invest it? It's like to maintain a mobile game, honestly, isn't that pricey, right? You have games on the other hand, like Girls Front Line, that for some reason can keep on existing at 200 or 300k, like revenue a month. And you'd really wonder how many employees they pay to go full-time keep up that game. It's actually sort of interesting to think about how Girls Front Line is doing. And also, like, how much they make from... Like, GFL makes no sense to most people, right? Because, like, they make far less reported numbers than, No worry, DBZ Kakarot is very better than my stream. Have fun, DBZ Kakarot, though. Money laundering. Who knows? Oh, wait, are you in the grindy part of Kakarot? I forgot how grindy that game is. I never did the game myself. I heard that game is rather grindy. I've never done it myself, though, so. As if you didn't know, Mattress, I stopped trophy hunting, like... 5 years ago, 6 years ago now? I forgot how many years ago. Still in the game, really enjoying... Wait, that has an original story. No, it doesn't have an original story, right? It's just based on... Or most of it is based on the original story, right? I mean, I would think most people who play Dragon Ball know the story, like, inside and out at this point. We started trophy hunting 5 years ago. Okay. But let me double check when my last, like, real trophy was. Like, there's a set of trophies I got, namely called Genshin, that I got, you know, the joke, sort of. Okay, never mind. That's a lie. I stopped trophy hunting technically 3 years ago. Last real like trophy I got were like FF7 remake, because you know FF7 came out, you know, first on PlayStation, so I had to go play that, and I'm just like, yay, FF7 remake. I technically got the Genshin Impact trophies, but like that's mostly because I just was syncing Genshin to my PlayStation for, you know, trophies. Like, I played Genshin for a fair bit before that point. I didn't really need to sync it. I only wanted the exclusive items. Yeah, we're all story version DVD shows. Makes sense. Only 50 plats, Mattress? Only 50? You know, you need enough Palzio there. Got 1,000 in 24 hours. You can get 50 in just, you know, what is it, 75 minutes? Or less, 1 hour, basically. You only need 1 hour, you can get 50 plats. Whoa! Yeah, I know, Mattress, I know. I only have, how many plats do I have? I have 204 plats, okay? I don't have that many. I'm also the type of person who always stressed variety over a lot of other things. I was a big fan of lowering my completion rate. This actually correlates very well. Like, for those of you who know me well, like, or don't know my anime habits at least, they know I do sample a lot of things. I actually had streams before where I would try to go play like 10 relatively long plat games and just like play them until I got one trophy, just so I could add them to my list and then move on to the next game and see how much fun I had in that game to go figure out if I want to come back to that game later. Like, have you ever seen my anime, actual anime list? I've dropped a lot of anime, a lot more than most people are willing to go. Most people think my account's a meme. Okay, that's how bad it is. It's fine. Yeah, but I do make it a point to try out as many things as I can. Okay, Quest! Sure, whatever you want to train it to be. I've seen one episode of JoJo in total. That's all I can say. I've seen one or two episodes. I never took the To Be Friends mattress. I never did, okay? I'm sorry, I never planned to be friends with you, if that was your answer. Okay. If you want to be friends, you can be. If not, then well. But yeah, like, I feel... Oh, shoot! It's the ending of Esuka and Logia? It sounds impossible! It's actually impossible! Okay, have fun, mattress. thank you. Okay, so, What was I gonna say? Oh, jeez. Oh, Zari's nailing it. This is seriously Starship? I do not know how Starship sounds like, honestly. Bad. Is it bad? I actually don't know what the right answer to that question. What else am I doing? So. I don't know who Xari nailed. I don't know the answer to that question, Esox. I'm just gonna go let it be. Well, Okay. Sorry, I'm still trying to also do work and also, you know, get enough water to go be half sane. Maybe not. I don't even know if I'm sane anymore, but, Bloodivores, right? Should be Bloodivores. Why can't I, like, actually type right now? I'm like, do you know how hard it is to scream while also doing work? It's so hard. Okay, there. We have it. I'm going to type down now. But yeah, I was gonna say about how basically how a lot of the mobile games are just so big these days that they will probably be like the things that will drive our future and how they spend their money. Because like how many AAA games you know can make as much money as Nikkei did? Like, there aren't many. Like, only like a fraction of AAA games has made as much money as Nikkei have, okay? That's like, it's actually pretty amusing to think about. And also how much work they put in versus how much money Nikkei put in is actually a meme, in some sense. or like, how much work we think they put in, okay? Maybe someone has like, the best algorithm for content creation ever in some of those games, but who knows? But yeah, they have a commanding amount of money. And they can use it to drive, well, whatever the heck they want to develop, except I don't know what else Azure Lane is doing other than, like, buying more animators. Like, I feel like Azure Lane bought out like enough animators to like go drive anyone crazy. Their model, like some of their live 2D models and whatnot, are absolutely wild. Like they're actually very, very impressive. I'm like, how much money do you spend on animation? I mean, it does pay itself off, I assume. Like, I'm assuming they're making the big bucks off doing it. But, like, is all we're gonna get is more animators at Azure Lane? Because, like, 10th anniversary happened for Azure Lane as of, like, I think, like, 1 or 2 weekends ago. And, I think, like, one of the people was commenting, it's like, there's no new gameplay features in this thing. The top, right? Like, on the other hand, like, you can see, like, Genshin investing all their money in, like, making more, like, more, like, content per area, per patch, because everyone demands more content every patch. It's honestly scary how the gamer mind thinks and wanting more content. Whether or not you enjoy the content or not, I'll leave that up to you. I probably know my answer to that, but it is fun to think about. It is very fun to think about. At least I find it fun to think about. Maybe you don't find it, but whatever. Well, I don't know why I'm in the mood to go talk about these topics right now, but I feel like it, okay? But yeah, there's just like some good food for thought in case you ever like think about businesses and also what's going to drive our future, because if you have money, you usually have more power to drive the future. Get money, so they can invest in something. What they'll invest into? Okay, this violence. Did you mind adventuring all the day? As for how much prison school predicts the future, I don't know about that one, Misox. You can probably see the new, if you've seen the new $60 skin Nikkei decided to go throw out in the school. It doesn't really accentuate ass that much as far as I'm concerned. But yeah, it's very interesting to see what Nikkei will try to do. $60 skins is actually pretty wild. Pretty wild. Yes, they introduced a $60 skin. It's not actually $60, but so yeah, you're right on that one, Accelerate. So it's not actually $60, but we're gonna, like, pretty much the entire player base says it is $60 because basically what Nikkei did was that they put their new skin in a pseudo gacha. Very much a pseudo gacha, okay? It's not actually a gacha. Yeah, I cannot do Eternity Memories. But yeah, they put it in a pseudo gacha where you get the gacha gets more expensive as you go along, and but the items you get on it are just marked off the checklist. But the item everyone wants, the skin, first and foremost, is not gettable until you've done at least 4 other rolls on that gacha. That must be the 5th roll or later on a 10 item wheel. So you had to go through 4 items first. It doesn't matter how good or bad your first 4 rolls are. That's already annoying. Then starting from there, But so yeah, you had to go. You can clear up the wheel. The clear up the wheel costs $60. So the chance of you getting the skin before clearing out the wheel, according to the odds, is less than 20%. It's like 19.4% chance of you rolling the skin before the 10th roll. But you do get some like half decent items in it. But you know, most people are in it just for the skin. Just for the skin. So we're going to treat it as a $60 skin. No one cares about anything else. Because most people aren't going to, you know, aren't playing hardcore and, you know, want every item they need under the sun to go, like, advance in the game. So yeah, Nikkei decided to pull off the $60 skin. Some people in the player base were angry as can be. Some just like, whatever. You know, there's a variety of opinions. You can read up on them. I'm not going to talk too much about it, about that part, because honestly, I don't care all that much. I'm like, the skin I'm not going to get. Whatever. Moving on. But yeah, so they did that. And we'll find out. I mean, you can obviously check, you know, you can obviously check Central Tower right now and whatnot if you ever want to figure out like how much money they made in the last few days. Technically, the gacha is still going on too. It's still ongoing. But usually everyone waits, you know, until the monthly Central Tower ranking to see how much money Nikkei made or didn't make this month. Central Tower is also a really weird measure nowadays because the amount of gacha games that have been going, like, PC clients have been increasing. So now we have, was it Punch and Gray Raven and Withering Waves both have the PC client now, if I recall correctly. So, like, that money is not being monitored at all by Central Tower. It's actually, like, it's gonna be weird Nikkei, though. Nikkei is gonna be always gonna be weird because you're literally playing at a disadvantage if you're playing on phone. You're literally behind on the meta. It's hilarious. It's like, if you're meta, you have to play on PC. No ifs, then buts about it. There is no better setup than playing on PC right now, which is hilarious. Or you're just going to do worse on competitive events. So, like, a lot of the whales play PC main. I recently joined a competitive guild, and, like, the leader doesn't want... Like, the leader's going to be on vacation for 3 days during a competitive event, and he wants someone else to play his account for him because, you know, he doesn't have access to a PC. And I'm pretty sure this is the normal stuff, right? I would ask the same thing. If I didn't have access to a PC. So, and the game's actually pretty decently PC optimized, which is the actual interesting part. They did a very good job with PC optimization. I'm honestly impressed how well Nikkei did the PC port. But like, oh, if they sent all their money through PC, how do you monitor how much money a game's making? Because, like, on one hand, why the heck? Oh, it's Nissan. I thought Accelerate knew this. So, like, why is Accelerate, you know, come? So, yeah, what was I gonna say? But yeah, so it's getting very hard to monitor how much money Nikkei actually made. Because she has these, like, months go on where, like, people are gonna play competitive events. And I said, every single person who's gonna main Nikkei is not gonna play on mobile. Like, the whales are not gonna be playing on mobile. Like, 100% sure of that. I guess it depends. Depends on what type of whale you are. If you're a whale not playing competitively, sure. If you're a whale and you want to play competitively, then yeah, you're going to PC. Like, you only do, like, at most dailies on your phone. But, like, if you're a whale, you're going to want to play on PC, right? Because that's where the action happens. Sort of a weird situation we're in nowadays. And I'm pretty sure this is being the case for, like, some of these more action-oriented games. Some of these action-oriented games take, you know, you can do a lot more with, like, keyboard controls and whatnot on a PC than you could ever do, like, on a phone. I'm sorry, because your phone doesn't have that many buttons and, you know, hotkeys and programming and whatnot for it. And on top of, like, Nikkei's, like, you know, questionable frame rate optimization on phones. Pokemon Unite. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Pokemon Unite had the exact same situation. Yeah, it's a very interesting situation on how that's all going to come out. Just like how, what's the best way for people to even track revenues, and also like how it was able to make games going forward. If you're going to say Nikkei is a decent PC game, then what's the point of making a AAA game? Huh. Interesting to think about. It's always interesting to think about, right? maybe not. Who knows? Okay, well, I've done enough ranting about random topics, probably docked myself many times over and whatnot, and said a whole bunch of really weird opinionated things that you may disagree on. But that's how it is. Yeah, that's how it is. So as it said in the stream title, we are going to be playing Path to Nowhere now. So, I need to start up Path to Nowhere. Okay, so let me go start up Path to Nowhere, because I forgot to do that much in life, because I'm an idiot. I wasn't prepared for this at all, because I was still trying to work, and I was like, I'm going through work, and I'm talking, and whatnot. But let me go start Path to Nowhere. I'm in the middle of starting it up. But we're going to be switching over to Path to Nowhere, and I'll be playing the new Broken Front Line in it, so that'll be interesting. You can go watch me struggle in it, or not struggle. It also might be super easy. I didn't even check how hard it was. All I know is new content. And so I might be struggling. I might find it a breeze. We'll find out very shortly, but hopefully that'll be entertaining for you all. If not, or you're not interested, or you just want to do something else, that's perfectly fine. Thank you for all for coming. It was great having you all. Thank you for hearing me rant for a long period of time and whatnot. Who knows? For those of you who care about, you know, watching me and whatnot, and watching me struggle and suffer and whatnot, please stick around. I'm just going to be stopping the stream and restarting it very shortly to go watch in 1080p. Yay, 1080p. So we'll be doing that. So look forward to that. And I guess that will be all. Yeah. So yeah, hopefully see you guys all within 1 minute. And we'll be off into races. Bye-bye.